discuss the formation of bus admittance matrix. Bus admittance matrix, it is also called as Y-bus matrix. Y-bus matrix. Okay. To form the Y-bus matrix, what data we require? We require the data of the transmission lines. Okay. So, we require the complete data of the transmission lines and the number of buses that are present in the power system network. So, data required is, first one, all transmission, all transmission line data and bus data. How many buses are there? How is there? Bus interconnection data. How the different buses are interconnected. Understand? So we have already discussed that all the transmission line in load flow analysis are modeled as nominal pi networks. Nominal pi networks. Understand? So usually the data would be given in this format. The data would be given in this format. So here, this is from bus. Let us call from bus as I. This is to bus. Let us call the bus to bus is J. So, and this is the resistance between the bus I and J, or IJ. This is the reactance, series reactance between bus I and bus J, and YIJ by 2 dash. This is the shunt admittance which is connected at the bus. Understand? Suppose, just for your understanding, if I draw a simple nominal pi network here. So this is bus I, this is the series impedance, and here, you know, there will be half of the shunt admittance connected at the beginning and other half is connected at the end of the transmission line. So let us call this is bus I and bus J. The total series impedance contains what? Resistance part as well as reactance part. Series resistance and series reactance. Here the shunt admittance, half of the shunt admittance is connected here. Half of the shunt admittance is connected at the end of the transmission line. Okay. So, like this, all the data will be given. Let us say, for example, it is a 3-bus system. Between bus 1 and bus 2, the resistance value is, let us say, 0.1. All values will be given in per unit. So, the series resistance of the transmission line that is connected between bus 1 and bus 2 is 0.1 per unit. The XIJ, let us call it as 0.5 per unit. The transfer admittance value he has given it as, say, 0.05 between the bus 1 and bus 2. So similarly, for between bus 2 and bus 3, the data value is, let us say, 0.15, 0.6 and it is 0.04. Between bus 3 and bus 1, the data is given as 0.08. This is 0.7 and this value is 0.0. Understand? So, like this, all the data will be given. But first thing we need to do is, we need to transform all the impedances into admittance. All the impedances into admittance. Okay. So, here if you add these two values, you are going to get series impedance. So, for suppose 0.1 plus J0.5 is the total series impedance. Okay. So, what I know from this data? The Z12, the transfer impedance, Z12 is the direct series impedance that is connected between bus 1 and bus 2. So, this I can call it as transfer impedance. Transfer impedance. Transfer impedance between bus 1 and bus 2 is Z12, whose value is given by what? 0.1 plus J 0.5. 5. Okay, now since I am dealing with an admittance matrix, I want admittance, transfer admittance between bus 1 and bus 2. So let us call this transfer admittance as y12. This y12 value is given by how much? 1 divided by z12. So this value will become, let us use the small symbols. Why we are using small symbols, I will tell you later. y12, this y12 is equals to 1 by z12. This is 1 by 0.1 plus j 0.5. so if you do simplification of this value, you are going to get some admittance value y12 as, do someone have calculator? Just calculate and tell.
0.384
minus
j 1.92.
So this is the per unit admittance. Okay, so likewise we calculate all the admittances value here. Let us call this other column, let us write in small letters, this also in small letters. So yij value, if you write, you are going to get three different values. Okay, three different values. What are the three different values you're going to get? y12, y23, and y31. Understand? So from the given data, first we calculate the admittances, the transfer admittances. Already the line charging admittances are given. So gentlemen, if you convert this into admittance, this value here, I'm writing the admittance value directly. So here, the two things you have to remember is that the direct admittance connected between bus I and bus J is called, this admittance is called transfer admittance, and this admittance we are calling it as yij dash by 2. This admittance is called line charging admittance. Or someone can also call it as shunt admittance. Okay. Whereas this is called transfer admittance. Or series admittance. Understand? So like this, from the given data, we'll get the all admittances. If impedance is given, first we'll convert it into admittance. And second important point is all the data is given in per unit. Understand? So for formulating Y-bus matrix, let us take a 3-bus system. So bus 1 value is V1. This is bus 1. V1 is equals to mod V1 at an angle delta 1. So similarly, this is bus 2. This is bus 2 where the value is V2. We are writing V2 is equals to modulus of V2 at an angle delta 2. This is bus 3 where the value is V3 is equals to mod V3 at an angle delta 2. Understand? Now, every transmission line, how we model it as a nominal pi. So if you model that in this fashion, let the shunt admittance here is this value. The shunt admittance connected at this bus is this one. The shunt admittance connected at this bus is this one. Okay. y13 dash by 2. Okay. Similarly, what would be the values for the bus, for the transmission line connected between bus 1 and bus 2? It would be y12 dash by 2. Similarly, for the transmission line connected between bus 2 and bus 3, they will become y23, y23 dash by 2 y23 dash by 2. Gentlemen, here you try to remember that y13 is same as y31. There is no difference. Similarly, y21 is same as y12, y23 is same as y23, because they won't change. That is, here y13 is same as y31, y23 is same as y32, and similarly y12 is same as y21. There is no difference between them. Okay, now since we have taken a 3-bus system and we have connected all the elements, all the admittances, okay, let if the current injected at bus 1 is I1, what is the current injected at bus 1? I1. Okay, so here we are assuming that at every bus some positive current is injected. Okay, here we are assuming that at every bus, at every bus, some positive current is injected. Some positive current is injected. Okay. So let the current injected at bus 1 is I1. This I1 again, after reaching this node, it gets bifurcated into what? Some current will go through in the transmission line between 1 and 3. Let us call this as I13. And this current is as I12. Okay. Again, this I13 current, some of this current will go into this one. This is, let us call it as I13 double dash. And this current as I13 dash. Similarly, here some current will flow through this one. This one I will call it as I12 double dash, and this current as I12 dash. Okay, now if you apply KCL at bus 1, by KCL at bus 1 you are having what? By the KCL at bus 1, you are having the current injected at bus 1 is equals to what? First one, it is I12 plus I13. Okay. So current injected I1 is equals to I13 plus I12. Okay. Again, how I can write I13? I13 is the sum of I13 dash plus I13 double dash. Okay. So this again will become I12 dash plus I12 double dash plus I13 dash plus I13 double dash. Okay, now what is this current I13 is the current that is flowing in this branch. I13 is the current flowing in this branch. How I can write this one? It is the, see here, the what is the bus voltage V1? The voltage at this point is same, that is V1 only. Okay, so here the voltage at this point is how much? V1. Here the voltage at this point is V. What you are going to get? I1 is equals to I12 dash. How I can write? I12 dash is equals to V1 minus V2 into Y12 plus I12 double dash will become V1 minus 0. I can remove V1 into Y12 dash by 2 plus I13 dash. I can write it as V1 minus V3 into Y13 plus this one is V1 into Y13 dash by 2. V1 minus V3. Okay. So V1 minus V3 into Y13. Voltage is V3. So here V1 minus V3 into Y13. Okay. V1 minus V3 into Y13. And I13 double dash is equals to V1 minus 0. Okay. This is simple correction. Here it is bus 3, not bus 2. Here it is bus 2. So these equations are correct. So if you simplify this one, you are going to get I1 is equals to, if I take V1 common, you are going to get V1 into Y12 plus Y13 plus Y12 dash by 2 plus Y13 dash by 2. Okay. If you take V2 common, V2 into, you are going to get minus Y12. If you take V3 common, you are going to get V3 into minus Y1. Minus Y1. Okay. Understand? So this is equation 1. This is equation 1. Okay. Similarly, we'll do for one more and then we will directly write the equation. Let the current injected at the bus 2 is, how much current is injected at bus 2? Let us call it as I2. Let us call it as I2. I2 is the current injected at a bus 2. Now what will happen? This I2 current will be divided into I23 and this one will be I21. This again I23 current will be divided into I23 dash and this one will be I23 double dash. Okay. Similarly, this current will become I21 dash and this one will be I21 double dash. Okay. So again, we are telling same exercise we are carrying out at bus 2, where current injected at bus 2 is I2. Again, this I2 current is divided into two different paths, I23 and I21. Again, this I21 is divided into I21 double dash and I21 dash. Similarly, I23 is divided into I23 double dash and I23 dash. So if you apply the KCL at bus 2, by the KCL at bus 2, what you are going to get, I am directly writing this one. I2 is equals to I21 plus I23, which I can write it as I21 dash plus I21 double dash. This one will be I23 dash. I23 dash plus I23 double dash. Okay. Now, how I can write this I21? I21, you can write it as, if you follow the same procedure, I21 dash. V2 minus V1 into Y12. I21 double dash will become V2 minus 0 into
Y12 dash by 2.
Understand? So likewise, if you do I23 dash is equals to V2 minus V3 into Y23, I23 double dash will become V2 minus 0 into V2 minus 0 into Y23 dash by 2. Y23 dash by 2. So if you put all these values, you're going to get directly, I'm writing, after simplification, I'm directly writing the step. I2 will become V1 into minus Y12 plus V2 into, you're going to get Y23 plus Y21 plus Y23 dash by 2 plus Y21 dash by 2 and V3 it is going to become minus Y23 dash by 2. This is equation 2. Likewise, if you do the exercise for bus 3, you're directly, I'm writing, I3 will become V1 into minus Y13 plus V2 into minus Y23 plus V3, it is going to become Y13 plus Y23 plus Y13 dash by 2 plus Y23 dash by 2. So like this, you are going to get three equations. Understand? So this is the first equation, this is the second equation, and this is the third equation. Okay. So now, if you can write all of these terms as in the form of a matrix, I can write this as current injected at bus 1, then just V1, V2 and V3. Okay. Understand? So these are the, these values are the currents injected at bus. Currents injected at the buses, and these are the bus voltages. Bus voltage vector, it's a vector. This is the current injected at bus, current injected at bus vector, and this is the bus admittance matrix. So to calculate bus admittance matrix, we need not carry out all this exercise. We can directly write the bus admittance matrix. If you can carefully observe, what is Y11? Y11 is given by, from this, if you can observe, your Y11 is nothing but this one. Okay. Your Y11 is this element. It is your Y12. It is your Y13. It is your Y21, Y22, and Y23. Similarly, this is Y31, Y32 and Y3. Okay. So any diagonal element is very easily obtained if you can carefully go and observe in this matrix. It is the sum of all admittances connected to that bus. See, what is Y11? Y11 is the sum of, Y11 is the sum of how many admittances are connected to bus 1. This is a bus 1. For this bus 1, how many admittances are connected? This is 1, 2, this transfer admittance 3, and this transfer admittance 4. Okay. So let us, this is also one admittance, we are writing in the form of circular. So for bus 1, in total 4 admittances are connected. If you add all these 4 admittances, you are going to get Y11. See, what is Y11? Y12, one admittance, two admittance, three and four. So if you add all the admittances connected to any bus, it is going to give the diagonal element of that bus, diagonal element of that bus. Similarly, for bus two also, what are the all admittances connected to bus two? For bus two, Y12 dash by two, Y23 dash by two. This is one admittance and this is one more admittance. Okay. So directly you can write the diagonal elements, that is, for any bus, the diagonal element is obtained by adding all the admittances connected to that bus, adding all the elements connected to that bus. Understand? Now, if you see any off diagonal elements, what are the diagonal elements? These are the diagonal elements. So, diagonal elements are easily obtained by adding all the admittances connected to that particular bus. Okay. Suppose YII. Yi is a diagonal element, which is given by sum of all admittances connected to ith bus. Understand? So Yii is the sum of all admittances connected to ith bus. Like this, you will get all the diagonal elements. Off diagonal elements, suppose we want to calculate Y12. What is Y12? Y12 is equals to minus of small Y12. Minus of small Y12. Similarly, Y13 is equals to what? Minus of small Y13. Y21 is equals to, Y21 is equals to, it is same as Y12. Okay, what we can observe is that Y12 is same as Y21. Y13 is same as Y31. Okay. And these values equals to minus of small y12. This is minus of small y1. Okay. So any off diagonal element is obtained by the transfer admittance between that. Here the Y12 is obtained by the negative symbol of the transfer admittance connected between bus 1 and bus 2. Bus 1 and bus 2. Okay. The two things you can observe is that Y bus matrix is a symmetrical matrix. Why? Because Y12 is same as Y21. Both are same. Y13 is same as Y31. So both are same. So it is a symmetric matrix. Because what is a symmetric matrix? If you take a transpose of that matrix, A transpose is equals to A, then you are calling it as a symmetric matrix. So Y bus matrix is a symmetric matrix. And second point is, any off diagonal is equals to minus of small yij, minus of small yij, where yij is the transfer admittance between bus I and bus j. Okay. So yij is the transfer admittance between bus I and bus j. So if you simply put minus symbol to it, you are going to get the off diagonal elements. So by simply looking at the network, if you know all admittances, you can construct the Y bus matrix. You can construct the Y bus matrix. Understand? The next important point is, many times our power system network is very big. Many times what happens? Many times all the buses are not connected with each other. Let us take it as a 4-bus system. There are 4 buses. So suppose the transmission line exists between, say, it is bus 1, bus 2, bus 3 and bus 4. Okay. Now this is the system. This is the system. The transmission line between these buses. Okay. Now how many buses are there? 4 buses. So what would be the size of Y bus matrix? For a 3-bus system, the size of Y bus matrix is 3 into 3. Likewise, for a n bus system, the size would be n into n. So here, what is the size of Y bus matrix? 4 by 4. But however, you can see there is no direct connection between bus 1 and bus 3. Okay, bus 2 and bus 3. So all the elements will not be present. All the elements will not be non-zero. Okay, here what are the elements that you can exist? You have, if a bus exists, then there will be non-zero Y11. So how many elements will be there? Y11 will be there, Y22 will be there, Y33 will be there, and Y44 will be there. R4, all the diagonal elements will be non-zero. Okay, but however, Y12 will exist because there is a transmission line connection between bus 1 and bus 2. So Y12 exists, which implies what? Capital Y12 exists, which implies capital Y21 also exists. Y14 exists, so it is equal to Y41. Okay, Y34 exists, which is equals to Y43. All these are non-zero. Okay. Now, can Y23 exist? Is Y23 possible? No, Y23 is not possible because there is no transmission line connected between bus 2 and bus 3. So, Y23 is 0. Similarly, Y32 is also 0. Okay. Now, can Y13 exists? Y13 is 0. Y31 is 0. Because there is no transmission line connection between bus 1 and bus 3. Bus 1 and bus 3. So, since in a power system network, many buses are not connected with many buses, so most of the elements in Y bus matrix will be zeros. Most of the elements will be zeros. Understand? Okay. So, here there is no transmission line between 2 and 3. So, your Y23 and Y32 are 0. There is no transmission line between 1 and 3. So, your Y13 and Y31 are 0. Understand? So how many zeros will be there here? Your capital Y11 exists. Y12 exists. y13 doesn't exist, y14 exists. Similarly here, y21 exists, this is 0, y41 exists. Similarly, y22 is there. y23, is there connection between 2 and 3? No, it is 0. y24 exists. So here it is 0, y24. And y33 exists. y34 exists because there is a connection. So it is y43 and y44 exists. So since two lines are missing here, so four elements will be 0. Four elements will be 0. Why? Because here two lines, that is line between 3 and 4 is missing. Line between 3 and 1 is missing. So two lines missing means four elements in the Y-bus matrix are 0. Understand? That is the concept. So if you go for the properties of Y-bus matrix, for an N-bus system, the size of Y-bus matrix is n cross n. Okay. The second property is, since the power system network is passive, Y-bus matrix is symmetrical matrix. Because all the elements in our power system network except the sources are all passive. So since the power system network is passive, Y-bus matrix is symmetrical. Okay. Since in a power system, the third point is, in a power system, it is not possible to connect every bus with one another. So most of the elements in Y-bus matrix are zeros. Most of the elements in Y-bus matrix are zeros. So Y-bus matrix is a sparse matrix. Y-bus matrix is a sparse matrix. Okay. So sparse matrix is the one in which the most of the elements are zeros. Okay. One more advantage of Y-bus being sparse matrix is that most of the calculation will be zeros. If the matrix contain more number of zeros, the calculations are simple. The memory requirement to store the data is also simple. So, advantages of sparse matrix. What are the advantages? It is calculations are simple. Why? Because most of the calculation will become zeros. Memory requirement. Memory requirement to store the data. Memory requirement to store the data is less. Is less. That's why we prefer Y-bus matrix for load flow analysis. Why? Because the calculations not simple, the calculations are minimal, and the memory requirement to storing the data is less. That's why we prefer Y-bus matrix for load flow analysis. Understand? So Y-bus matrix is non-singular. Non-singular means the determinant is non-zero, so inverse exists. Inverse for Y-bus matrix exists, and inverse of Y-bus matrix is the Z-bus matrix. Okay, so if you inverse the Y-bus matrix, you are going to get the bus impedance matrix of the power system. Bus impedance matrix of the power system. Okay, now the important point is, if we add all elements in the ith row or ith column of the Y-bus matrix, we get the shunt admittances connected to the ith bus. We get the shunt admittances connected to the ith bus. So if you go to the matrix, if you add any row or any column, what you are going to get, if you add any of these rows, you are going to get y12 and minus y12 will get cancelled. y13 and minus y13 will get cancelled. So if you add all the row elements, what you are going to get? y12 by 2 plus y13 by 2. Okay. So what are Y12 dash by 2 and Y13 dash by 2? These are the shunt admittances connected to that bus. These are the shunt admittances connected to that bus. That means if you add any row or any column in Y-bus matrix, you are going to get the shunt admittances connected to that bus. Shunt admittances connected to that bus. Understand? So if you add all elements in ith row or ith column, you are going to get the shunt admittances connected to the ith bus. Okay. Next, capital YII, the diagonal element, indicates self-admittance of ith bus. Indicates self-admittance of the ith bus. It is sum of all admittances connected to the ith bus, which we have already seen. So any diagonal element we can easily obtain by adding all the admittances connected to that particular bus. Similarly, YIJ indicates the transfer admittance between ith bus and jth bus with negative polarity. We have already seen that capital YIJ is equals to minus of small YIJ, where small YIJ is the transfer admittance connected between the ith bus and the. Now, let us take a simple question. So this is the Y-bus matrix for a 4-bus system. Now he's asking, what are the buses that are having shunt elements? What are the buses that are having shunt elements? That means shunt admittances. So for this, what we have to do, if we add any row or any column, what we are going to get? If we add any row or any column, suppose if I add first row or first column, sum of row 1 elements. Sum of row 1 elements will give you what? Shunt admittances connected to bus 1. Understand? So sum of row 1 elements or sum of column 1 elements will give you shunt admittances connected to that bus. So if I add all rows, if I add first row sum, what I am going to get? So row 1 sum is how much? Minus 5?
Minus 0.5.
Minus 0.5, which is a non-zero. Which is a non-zero. So there is some shunt elements that are connected at the bus 1. Theek hai? Similarly, row 2 sum is how much? Row 2 sum is?
Minus 1.5.
Minus 1.5, which is also non-zero. Row 3 sum is how much? 0. Row 4 sum is?
0.
So, if you add all the row elements, if you get non-zero, that means what is the indication? Some shunt elements are connected to that. So some shunt elements or shunt admittances are present. Shunt elements are present at bus 1 and bus 2, whereas there are no shunt admittances or shunt elements connected to bus 3 and bus 4. So which is the right option? Option C is the right option. So, the buses having shunt elements are bus 1 and bus 2. You can easily calculate by adding all the row sums. Okay. Next is given the network. For the given network, he is asking, what is Y22? What is Y22? So, the power system network he has given. So, first thing you have to notice is that while calculating the admittance matrix, all the elements must be represented in their admittances. All the elements must be represented in their admittances. But if you see here, the inductor, when it is represented as impedance, the J value is positive. Okay. For inductor, for reactor or inductor, both are same. For reactor or inductor, when J polarity is positive, plus J indicates what? Plus J indicates that it is represented in impedance. Plus J indicate impedance. Okay. For the same inductor and reactor, minus J indicates what? It is admittance. Admittance. Understand? For capacitor, plus J indicates what? Plus J indicates admittance. For capacitor, minus J indicates impedance. Okay. So here, by looking at all the polarities of J, you can tell that all the elements are represented in their impedance form. Because all inductors are having plus J symbol, all capacitors are having minus J symbol. So all the elements in the given network are represented as impedances, per unit impedances. So first step is you have to convert them into per unit admittances. So if you convert each element into admittance, what you are going to get? So reciprocal of J 0.1 will be how much? It will become minus J10. I am writing all admittances in green. So it is minus J10. This one is also minus J10. Here this value will become plus J 0.1. This value become plus J 0.05. This value will become plus J 0.0. Okay. Remember, inductor is having minus J polarity, capacitor is having plus J polarity. So all these are the admittances. All these are the admittances. Now you know all the admittances. We can very easily calculate the bus admittance matrix. Now tell me, what is the first element Y11? How we can get the Y11? Y11 is obtained by adding all the admittances connected to bus 1. So Y11 will become how much? All the admittances connect, addition of all admittances connected to bus 1. This one is how much? Minus J10 plus J0.05. This value will become J minus J9.95 is Y11. Okay. Similarly, Y22 value will be how much? Sum of all admittances connected to bus 2. Here, how many are connected? 3 admittances, 1, 2, and 3. If you add all this, what you are going to get? Minus J10 plus J0.05. This value is going to become how much? Minus J19.95. That is the Y22 value. Similarly, Y33 value will become how much? Sum of all admittances connected to bus 3. This value will become, here 2 admittances are connected, minus J10 plus J0.1. So this is minus J9.9. Minus J9.9. This is the admittances Y3. So very easily we can tell you what is Y12. Y12 is the negative of the admittances connected between 1 and 2. That is minus Y12, that is equals to minus of, what is Y12? Minus J10. What is the transfer admittance connected between bus 1 and bus 2? It is minus J10. So it will become minus of minus J10. This value is plus J10. Similarly, Y13 does not exist. Y13 is 0 because there is no connection between bus 1 and bus 3. So Y13 is 0. So Y13 is 0. Y23 is equals to minus of Y23. That is minus of minus J10. This value will become plus J10. Okay. So if you write every data in the matrix form, what you are going to get? Here I am using the space. So Y bus matrix is equals to, what is Y1? Let me write J outside so our life will become easy. minus 9.95. So for every element, there is J symbol which we have taken outside. So this is the Y-bus matrix. This is the Y-bus matrix. Since he's only asking Y22 value is how much? J into Y22 is minus J into 19.95. So option D is the right option. Option D is the right option. So first only thing you have to make sure is that whether the data is given in impedance form or admittance form. So if the data is given in impedance form, then first you have to convert into admittance form, and then by direct inspection you can form the Y-bus matrix. Okay. So this is the third type of problem. The bus admittance matrix is given. So, in the bus admittance matrix of a 3-bus system is given, each transmission line between two buses is represented as a nominal pi network, equivalent pi network. Each transmission line is represented as a equivalent pi network. The magnitude of shunt susceptance, the magnitude of shunt susceptance of the line connecting bus 1 and bus 2 is. So, he is asking, every transmission line is represented as a nominal pi network, bus 1 and bus 2. Let us call this is bus 1 and bus 2. Okay, then these values will become y12 dash by 2. This is y12. Okay, now he is asking the shunt susceptance of the line between 1 and 2. So he is asking the value of, this is the half of the shunt susceptance. This is half of the shunt susceptance. So he's asking the sum of these two values. He's asking sum of these two values in the given system. Okay. We have to extract y12 dash. What we need? We need to calculate y12 dash. That is the question. Okay. So it's very simple to extract y12 dash. First, you know, if you add all the row one sum, you're going to get what? Row one sum is only these elements. Shunt admittance is connected to that bus. You won't get these elements. So now if we add these two and subtract this one, what you're going to get? This element and this element is cancelled. So plus plus minus. So you're going to get it as 2. What is the answer? 2 is the answer. Okay. So I'll tell you a simple trick. Most of the buses will be 3 bus matrices only which they will give to you. So y12 dash is equals to y12 dash, if you want to find out, very simple trick is that add row 1, add row 2, subtract the left out row. What is the left out row? Similarly, if they ask y23 dash, add row 2 plus row 3 plus, what is the remaining row? Row 1. You subtract row 1. Understand? So likewise, if they ask y13 dash, add row 1 plus row 3 and subtract row. That is a technique to find out the shunt susceptance of any transmission line in the given Y-bus network. Okay. So here he is asking Y12 dash. For that you add row 1, row 2 and subtract the sum of row 3. You are going to get the value. So option B is the right option in this case. Okay. So the next question is, in a power system network which contains 50 buses, Y-bus matrix is 50% space. Y-bus matrix is 50% space. Determine the number of transmission lines in the power system network. Determine the number of transmission lines in the given network. Okay, So very simple question, but very interesting question. So how many buses are there? Let the number of buses be n. Number of buses is equals to 50. Total elements in Y bus matrix. Total elements in Y bus matrix is equals to how many? N into n. That is 50 into 50. How many? 2500 elements are present in the Y bus matrix. Okay. Now, total non-zero elements. Total non-zero elements in Y bus matrix. 50% are sparse. That means what is the meaning? 50% of them are zeros. Okay. Suppose if it is 80% sparse. So what is the meaning? 80% of the Y bus matrix elements are zeros. Understand? So the total elements is 2500, out of which 50% are zeros. So how many non-zero elements will be there? 2500 into 1 minus 0.5, that is equals to 12,050. I am telling you a simple formula. The total number of non-zero elements in Y bus matrix is given by n into 1 minus x. N into 1 minus x, where x is the per unit sparsity of Y bus matrix. Okay, so x value for 50% sparse, your x value will become 0.5. For 80% sparse, your x value will become 0.8. For 90% sparse, your x value will become 0.5. Understand? So here 50% sparse, so our x value is 0.5. So number of non-zero elements will become n into n multiplied by 1 minus per unit sparsity. Sparsity is given by that percentage value divided by 100. Okay. So here the number of non-zero elements is 1250. Okay. So out of 1250 non-zero elements, we know that every diagonal element is non-zero. So 50 of them are diagonal elements and 1200 of them are non-diagonal elements. Okay. Understand? 1200 are the non-diagonal elements. So for every transmission line, suppose one transmission line vanishes, two elements are becoming zero. If one transmission line is present, two off-diagonal elements are becoming non-zero. So for every transmission line, two non-zero off-diagonal elements exist. So for every transmission line, two non-zero off-diagonal elements will exist. So for 1200 non-diagonal off-diagonal elements, how many transmission line will exist? 600 transmission line will exist. 600 transmission lines will exist. Okay. So for 1200 non-zero off-diagonal elements, 600 transmission lines will exist. Understood? So the number of transmission line equal to very simple formula. number of transmission lines plus number of transformers. Remember this formula. Number of transmission lines plus number of transformers in a power system network is equals to number of non-zero off diagonal elements, number of non-zero off diagonal elements divided by number of non-zero off diagonal elements divided by 2. It will give you the total sum of transmission lines and transformers present in the power system network. Understood? Very, very important relationship where the total number of transmission lines and transformers present in the power system network is given by the number of non-zero off diagonal elements in Y-bus matrix, divided by 2. Okay. First, you have to calculate the non-zero off diagonal elements of Y-bus matrix and you have to divide it with the 2. Understand? So, for calculating number of off diagonal elements, first you have to calculate the number of non-zero elements. Non-zero elements we can easily calculate. Non-zero elements in Y-bus matrix is given by very simple. That is total elements multiplied by 1 minus sparsity. 1 minus sparsity. Okay. So non-zero off diagonal elements is given by first you after calculating this value n into 1 minus x, subtract with the diagonal elements, that will be again n. So number of transmission lines plus transformers is given by this whole value divided by 2, that is n into 1 minus x minus n divided by 2. If you take n common, what you are going to get? If you take n common, you are going to get n into 1 minus x minus 1 divided by 2. Okay, so this will give you directly the number of transmission lines and transformers present in the power system network, where n is the number of buses, x is the per unit sparsity of the bus. Either you can directly remember the formula or you can remember the procedure. Okay, understood the question? Okay, 80 bus power system network has a Y bus matrix which is 90% sparse. Find the total number of transmission lines and transformer present in the power system network. So n is how much here? 80. So the total number of elements would be 80 into 80. Sparsity is 90%, so number of non-zero elements will become how much? Number of non-zero elements will be 80 into 80 multiplied by 1 minus sparsity is 0.9. So this value will be 640. So total 640 elements are non-zero, out of 640 the diagonal elements are 80. So number of non-zero off diagonal elements will be 640 minus 80, so it is 560. So number of transformers plus transmission lines will become 560 divided by 2. This will become 280. 280 is the right answer. So the total number of transformers and transmission lines is equal to 280. Understand? So next we will discuss how the transformer is modeled or how the transformer is modeled in the Y-bus matrix. When a transformer is connected between ith bus and jth bus. Okay. Now, let us assume the connection is such that, as we are showing it here. So, this is the bus I. This is the total admittance of the transformer, and let us call this point as T, small t. And here the transformer, ideal transformer, is connected. And this is bus T, bus J. So this is I bus, this is the jth bus. Here this value, let us call it as yij, small yij. Okay. The tap ratio of the transformer is 1:8. 1:8. The temporary node that is created here is, let us call it as T. Okay. Now, what we are doing, we are assuming a transformer is connected between the bus I and bus J, and transformer is represented as its series admittance. So yij is the, and the tap ratio is 1:8. Nominal tap ratio is 1:8. 1:8 is the tap ratio. Okay. Now, small t is the imaginary bus between tap ratio and series admittance of transformer. Okay. Understand? So here, very simple. We have taken bus I and bus J. Between bus I and bus J, a transformer is connected. So for this transformer, what we have done? The total series admittance of the transformer we have lumped and we have denoted it as yij. And here we have connected an ideal transformer who is simply having a tap ratio of 1:8. Sir, when we studied the per unit system and fault analysis, we modeled the per unit representation of transformer is how much? Per unit representation of transformer is like this. Okay. So where the I per unit is same, this is V1 per unit, this is V2 per unit, and this one we call it as Z equivalent per unit. So here your yij is nothing but the inverse of this Z equivalent per unit. Nothing to worry about it. So your yij here, your yij is nothing but reciprocal of your per unit transformer series impedance, that is one Z equivalent per unit. Just I am correlating what you know and what I am using here. Understand? So your yij is nothing but the 1/Z equivalent per unit value. Okay. Now, from this relationship, what I can write, let the current injected at bus I is, I am calling it as II. Current injected at bus I is II. Current injected at bus J is, I am calling this as IJ. Okay. Now, from the transformer relationship, I can write it as the voltage at bus J, that is VJ, and voltage at bus T is, let us call it as VT. Now, can anyone tell me what is the ratio between these voltages? The bus J voltage is VJ and bus T voltage is VT. The ratio between, what is the relation between these two voltages?
VT into A VJ.
VJ by, yeah, very good ma'am. VJ by VT is equals to A. Understand? VJ by VT is equals to A. Any doubt? No. Now, what is relationship between the current II divided by IJ will become how much? Minus A. Why? Because the current directions are opposite. So here the currents will become, if you change the direction of any of these currents, then the ratio will become what? Minus A. Okay. Now the next thing is II, current injected at bus I, II is equals to the voltage at this bus, let us call it as VI, VI minus VT into YIJ. Can I write like this? Current injected at bus II is equals to voltage of this bus minus voltage at the T bus multiplied by the admittance, that is YIJ. Okay. The same thing I can write it as VI minus VT. How I can write? VT is equals to VJ by A. VJ divided by A into YIJ. YIJ. Okay. That is the first relationship. Let us call this one as, let us call this, let us call this relationship as 1. 1. Okay. Now, similarly, can you tell me how I can write IJ? IJ will become current injected at bus J. IJ will become how much? IJ is equals to, again, I will not do any calculation, it will become minus of capital II, current injected at bus I, divided by A. So from this relationship, what I am getting? From this relationship, I am getting IJ is equals to, IJ is equals to, I am taking this to this one. So it is equals to minus 1 by A into II. Okay. I already know equation for II. If I substitute in that, what I am going to get? Minus of 1 by A into VI minus VJ by A into YIJ. Okay. Let us call this as equation 2. So if I write equation 1 and equation 2, what I am going to get? VJ by A square into YIJ. VJ by A square into YIJ. Okay. So if you write it this in the form of a matrix, you are going to get II by IJ. Stroke is troubling us today. II divided by IJ, that is equals to the matrix into VI in VJ. So here you can write these elements as YIJ minus YIJ by A. This element is minus YIJ minus YIJ by A plus YIJ by A square. Understand? These are the four elements that you are going to get, that is YIJ minus YIJ by A minus YIJ by A, YIJ by A square. See, again, it is a symmetric, because transformer is a symmetrical and reciprocal element. So it is also a symmetric matrix. So once anybody gives you a transformer, the equivalent Y bus matrix will be very simple to find out. Understand? The next is equivalent pi network for a tap changing transformer. Tap changing transformer. So I'm directly writing the this one. So for the for this representation, I'm writing the nominal pi equivalent of the transformer. So this value will become of the bus. So if it is bus I, if it is bus j, okay, so this element let us call them as ABC, A, B and C. So A plus B will become YIJ. So likewise you will get the equivalent pi network for a tap changing transformer. If anybody asks, A value is YIJ divided by A, B value is YIJ into A minus 1 by A, C value is YIJ into 1 minus A by A square. Okay, so this is the representation of transformer in a Y-bus matrix, in a Y-bus matrix. Okay, just to remember this matrix, if this is the equivalent pi network of a tap changing transformer, variances are given by these values. Okay. Static load flow equations. Okay. On the Y-bus matrix, what you can remember, your I1 is equals to, if you recollect your 3 by 3 matrix, I1 will become how much? Y11 into V1 plus Y12 into V2 plus Y13 into V3. This is your current injected at bus 1 is given by this one. Suppose if it is having a n bus system, then it's going to become Y14 into V4 like this dash 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 Y1n into Vn. Like this you are going to get the equation for I1. Similarly for I2, what you are going to get? Y21 into V1 plus Y22 into V2 plus Y23 into V3, so on and so forth, you are going to get Y2n into Vn. Okay, so if you generalize this one, current injected at the ith bus is given by k, summation of k equal to 1 to n Yik into Vk. You can write it this one. So current injected at the ith bus is given by summation of k equal to 1 to n Yik into Vk. Okay, now complex power injected at bus I. We already know what is the complex power injected, that is Pi plus jQi. Pi plus jQi, that is equals to Si. Okay, complex power injected at bus I is given by Pa plus jQa, that is equals to Si, whose value we have already computed as Sga minus Sdi. We know all these values. Okay. So now this value we can also obtain, that is complex power injected at ith bus Si equals to Vi into Ii conjugate. Vi into Ii conjugate. Okay. So what is Vi? Vi into I1, Ii value is we already know, that is summation of k equal to 1 to n Yik Vk whole conjugate. Vi is equals to summation of k equal to 1 to n Yik Vk conjugate. Okay, we already know that Vi, how we can write it as in polar form, we can write Vi as mod Vi at an angle delta I. Similarly, Vk we can write it as mod Vk at an angle delta K, and Yik, Yik means it is the admittance, transfer admittance connected between bus I and bus K. If you write it in a rectangular form, you are going to get conductance minus susceptance, because most of the series elements will be resistance and inductance. When you convert resistance and inductance into admittance, you are going to get conductance and the susceptance, which is negative. Okay, so if I write this in the polar form, I can write this Yik as magnitude of this one square root of Gik square plus BIK square, that is the magnitude into tan inverse of, this will be negative, that is BIK by GIK minus BIK by GIK. So this entire YIK, I can write it as mod YIK into this angle, I am calling it as, this angle, I am calling it as gamma IK. Okay. So this is the, how I represent all the elements in the polar form. Okay. So continuing this equation. So here I am writing every element as a magnitude and some angle. For voltage, it is voltage magnitude and power angle or the voltage angle of that bus. For admittance, it is the square, the magnitude multiplied by the angle, which is given by tan inverse of the susceptance divided by the conductance. Susceptance divided by the conductance. So SI will become VI into summation of k equal to 1 to n YIK VK whole conjugate. So if I write everything in terms of its voltage and magnitude, that is PI plus JQI will become mod VA at an angle delta I into of K equals to 1 to N. So this I am writing it as mod YIK. This is gamma IK. If I take conjugate, it is becoming minus gamma IK because of conjugate. And this value will become mod VK into minus delta K because of the conjugate. So I have taken conjugate inside, both the angles became negative. If I multiply this term inside, I am going to get PI plus JQI is equals to, every time I am multiplying with this one, you are going to get summation of K equals to 1 to N mod VA into mod VK into mod YIK. Okay. This delta is positive, but however, so if you split it into real and imaginary parts, your PA is going to become how much? Your PA is going to become sigma k is equals to 1 to n, sigma k is equals to 1 to n mod VA into mod VK into YIK into cos of delta I minus delta K minus gamma IK The QI value is going to become summation of K equals to 1 to N mod VA into mod VK into YIK into sine of delta I minus delta K minus gamma IK So these two equations will give you the real and reactive power injected at bus I and bus Q respectively. Okay. These two equations will give you real and reactive power injected at bus I and bus Q, bus I respectively, real and reactive power. So these are called static power flow equations. Static power flow or power injected equations. So one thing which you have to remember here, to calculate the power injected at any bus, you need to know all the voltage magnitudes. You need to know all the voltage magnitudes and all the voltage angles. Without the data, you will not be able to calculate the real power injected value and reactive power injected value. Okay. You need to know the voltage magnitudes, voltage angles and the bus admittance patterns. Then only you will be able to find out the real and reactive power injected at any bus. Okay. Now, to calculate the voltage value of the bus, what you have to do? So we know that the complex power injected is given by SI is equals to VA into IA conjugate. So from this, what I can write? SI. If I write SI conjugate, if I take conjugate on both sides, it's going to become VA conjugate into IA conjugate whole conjugate. If I take conjugate on both sides, I'm going to get this value. So SI conjugate will become PI minus JQI is equals to VI conjugate into II, because conjugate into conjugate they'll cancel, you'll get II. Okay. So from this data, how I can write this one? VI conjugate into sigma k is equals to 1 to n yik vk. So this value I can write it as PI minus JQI is equal by VI conjugate is equals to sigma k is equals to 1 to n yik vk. Okay, I am taking this PI conjugate to this side. This total sum I can write it as, I am splitting this into yii vi. I am taking one term out of the summation, plus sigma k is equals to 1 to n, but k not equals to I. I can write this one as yik vk, because I have taken this step outside, yii vi outside. So from this, what I am going to get, yii vi is equals to yiivA will become PI minus JQI divided by VI conjugate minus of summation of k equals to 1 to n YIK VK. Okay. That is this term. YIA into VA. So if I want only VI, my VA will become voltage of the ith bus is given by 1 by YII, 1 by YII into PI minus JQI divided by VI conjugate. So this equation will give you the voltage of the ith bus. So in entire load flow, you have to remember those power injected at the ith and the qth bus, and the second one is the voltage of the ith bus. So voltage of the ith bus is given by this simple formula, where YIA is the self admittance of the ith bus, PI is the real power injected at the ith bus, QI is the reactive power injected at the ith bus. Okay. So it is, the above equation is a non-linear algebraic equation. For which there is no direct method of solution is available. To solve above equations, what we need? We need to go for numerical methods. Understand? So here in today's class, what we have done? We have formulated the YBUS matrix for a given power system network. First, without the transformers, considering only transmission lines. Then we have formulated the YBUS matrix for a transformer that is connected between two buses, and we have derived the static power flow equations, that is the real power injected and reactive power injected at the ith bus. And the last one is, we have derived one more equation for the voltage at the ith bus. Voltage of the ith bus is given by this formula. Here this voltage contains both magnitude and phase angle. That means your VA contains the data. If you take the magnitude, you are going to get mod VA. If you take the angle of this one, you are going to get delta I. So we derived the expression for the voltage of the ith bus, and it is a non-linear algebraic equations. To solve this non-linear algebraic equations, we don't have standard methods. We go for numerical methods.